Good evening, people. You have to let me know how well this sounds, because I've got a new mic set up. Give it a couple more minutes and I'll kick over to my bench here. Not too long. Any of you out there, can you hear me tonight? Okay, how is that? Because it's a new condenser mic that I set the levels kind of low because I didn't want to blow people's eardrums out when I first talked. Okay, yeah, we'll just have to play with the volume level and make sure I get it right, because I got my new toy, or one of them. Yeah. Let's see, is this going to be right set up when I put it on? So this is what I bought. It's got the mic, the interface box, an XLR cable, and a set of headphones. It also comes with the Studio One software for mixing my own audio, but we'll see how that goes, because I don't think you can do it live, so that'd be more if I start recording something. Next up, I have a little mail that I got today. You can see I crossed out all my name and stuff, so you guys don't know my address. That didn't work so well. Let me get a sharper knife. I think I already know what this is, but it should be parts to my new computer. And it is. It's a couple of SATA cables and this little guy. Yep. It's a mount for my SSDs when I get my SSDs. So we'll have fun with that when I go to build this computer. It almost feels like plastic, but it's punched aluminum. And you guys have all seen SATA cables. I just bought, this should be a 3-pack. Yep, there's 6 connectors in there, so it's a 3-pack. Safely put this stuff for right now. Up here with my thin mints. Another couple of things. I was going to try to make the delay on my video a little less by... I stripped this out of a old DVR. You know, it's a standard PCI card. And then this back plane that's got all the BNCs. And evidently these are individual audio jacks for each camera. I did not know that about this recorder. But it's a proprietary one made by Vicon. It uses some off-the-shelf chips, but... All the drivers out there on the internet for it don't work on a 64-bit system. They only work on 32-bit. So this might not be viable. I'll try it later and see, but I'm not too hopeful. What's this? Oh! That was the schematic for the noisemaker last week. Now, I was going to show you another thing. Do a quick little thing on how to test batteries. This guy Don't know if you're familiar with Ryobi. It does say that it's got a charge in it. But it doesn't work. You put it in the drill, nothing happens. I already took the screws out. Yeah, I wish my whole computer was cheaper, Mr. Wells. Anyways, there's usually a set of screws that hold it together, and then the top comes off. There's a little heat insulating spacer there. Then you got the sides that come off. Each manufacturer's gonna be a little different on how it comes apart. But you'll see rows of 18 650 cells that are spot welded together. Get a voltmeter out here. Set up 20 volts. And shot here. If you test across the battery, you'll see it. Oh, I've got more than 20 volts across the battery. So it says I've got 20 volts on this pack, which each one of these is 4.2. So 4.2 plus 4.2, that's 8.4 plus another 8.4, that's 16.8, plus another 4.2, should be 21 volts across this battery pack, but I'm only getting 20. Now, of course, it's regulated down, should be regulated down to 18 volts, it's only coming out 15. But what you can do on these is you can test across each set of cells. So like that one, okay, 4.1, not too bad. Yeah, it's hard to do this and keep things in shot. Just across there. See, that one's at 3. And then this set, 4.1, 4.0, and 4.1. So basically, one of the two cells in here has gone bad. Or possibly both. And so it's drawing the whole current of the battery pack down, and which is why this doesn't work. If I wanted to spend the time, I could sit here and pop these off and spot weld in new 18650 cells, or I can buy a whole pack of 10 of them for probably cheaper than this battery pack. But then I gotta spot weld them on, and I don't have any way to do that. So what I'm probably gonna do is salvage the 18650s out of this that are good and keep them around for my battery pack. And, you know, I have a couple of rechargeable battery packs for cell phones and stuff. And those might become replacement batteries for my cell phone chargers. Yeah, I do run across a few unusual things, Mr. Wells. And now that I'm into an industry that does both security, HVAC, and building controls, yeah, I've got some other strange things that pop up in my collection. So So on this, yeah, I still got to see if it's worth my time to replace the bad cells, or like I said, in the case, usually buy all new cells across the board for it. It's probably going to be cheaper just to buy one of these whole pre-built battery packs and just scrap this whole one. Speaking of obscure things, can anybody guess what that is? Yes, I am streaming, Jacob. It was Phillips the whole time. Yeah. So anyways, that little device, or big device I had on the bench, that is an electronic valve controller. And I don't know if you can see it down in there, but right here, the skid mark and the hole, it's hard to see down in there. But that's what happens when some doofus hooks up 110 volts instead of 24 volts. My boss wanted to see if I could fix it or not, to keep it around as a spare. Yeah, it's not worth it. So I'm gonna probably scrap the motor out of it. Because it's a nice synchronous 24 volt AC motor. Yeah, we were surprised that it didn't cause more smoke than it did. But that little diode did its job and protected the rest of the system from going super critical. Let's go back together. Yeah, I'll fight with it later. I've got a stream to do. Hi, Jinx and Spoon. Yeah, Jinx, from the looks of it, all it did was it fried the input protection diode, which that's what that diode's supposed to do, so maybe the rest of it is okay, and the microprocessor's still good if I can get past that diode. Which is one reason it's under the bench, awaiting to see if I want to do things with it or not. Oh, yeah, sorry about that, Spoon. You weren't here for that. I got a new mic set up. So, here's this. And the way it works is I've got it plugged into this. And you can see, you know, mic one, mic two. Oh, you kind of can't because there's a glare. Let's see, where's that glare coming from?
Possibly from the light.
There we go. I think I got it. But yeah, you've got mic one and mic two. Mic one comes in on the left, mic two comes in on the right. I need to get a mixing board to balance that out. It's on my next round of purchases. Let me see if there's anything I can do for you on my end. Properties. Is that any better, Spoon? Okay, yeah. So I still have to get, so I can balance that out. Well, I could switch the mic to the other input, and then you'd have, then it'd be all right. But that's the other thing that I did. Let me make sure that's all the way down. Because now if you do this, you can probably hear. Oh, he's down way low. That's coming out of our Arduino bot. So you guys can hear the music now as it plays. Which, I changed the music. Again, I gotta, my next purchase is, it's already in my basket. I just gotta wait until I get my next paycheck. I moved it to a list, that's right. I moved it to sound equipment. So my next purchase is probably going to be that right there, so I can pan myself to come out both left and right, as well as control the mix level between Arduino bot and my mics a lot better than with this little box. I was hoping that the studio software that comes with my the Personas was able to do live mixing on the computer. But so far, in just poking around and playing with it, it's only for recorded music. So, that's why I'm working on getting this to fix my audio. But I gotta wait for my next paycheck, which is next Friday, in order to do that. Unless somebody kindly donates enough for me to buy it. But I don't expect it because it's $60. Now, back to my LED board, cube. Off camera, today after work, I did a little prep work. I built me a jig. Didn't think you guys wanted to sit here and watch me drill an 8x8 grid of 1/8-inch holes. And what this is for, when I go to actually start building the layers of LEDs, stick them in, bend the leads, solder them together. That's one of the other things I got to do, is I got to go through this entire bag and test to make sure all those LEDs work before I start soldering them together. Because nothing worse than getting an entire layer done and having to extract a dead LED. Now, if I kill it during soldering, that's a whole nother thing. Let's see. Where to start? I've got that. All the parts. Don't need that part yet. That's at the end. I also went through here and made sure I have enough parts to do the entire project. Made sure there wasn't any missing. And from what I've pieced together on the very lacking documentation from this thing, that what resistors go where. So I'm almost wondering if I shouldn't just start the tedious process of testing LEDs and counting to make sure I have enough. Because that's the other thing. There should be at least 512 of them in here, which is how many I need. Things off. My son is watching YouTube videos on his computer behind me and decided he wants to talk too. Okay. This is a lot of LEDs. A lot of LEDs. Let's see, short leg should be negative, I believe, if I remember my LEDs correctly. Yep. It's gonna be a nice blue one. You know what? There's a quicker way to do this. I'm not thinking smartly. I'm just trying to think where that piece is. I need... Okay. What I need is a wireless or a solderless breadboard.
Black wire and the red wire. Box of goodies goes back up. Yeah, put it back up here.
Okay, now the trick. Clip my leads for my power supply to those. Now all I have to do is stick it in there. Yay! And it lights. This is going to be a long and tedious part. So what do you guys want to talk about while I do this? Because I'm almost wondering, should I do it? Because I want to try to get a layer started here. Birthday money is always fun to spend, Mr. Wells. I swear I'll get into soldering something together here in a minute. I just want to get enough for the first layer. And then we'll start soldering the layer together. I realized I forgot that I flipped my mic around and it was facing away from me. Towards all the noise that my kids are making in the hallway. It's like they know I'm streaming. Isn't that the case with kids and pets? They always seem to know when they're not supposed to make noise. And my phone's making noise. Cheesecake is always good, Mr. Wells. Oh, it's Amazon letting me know that my package has arrived. A little late. Okay. That might not be enough, but I'm gonna start here. Okay. So what we want. Slightly bent. You mean Sony let them add something to the game? I figured it took like an act of Congress to get anything updated on the PlayStation Network. I'm kind of glad my computer wasn't capable of running that game, so I didn't get sucked into the hype of that. It's PlayStation Network that killed that game. From everything that I saw on all the previews and everything before Sony got a hold of it, it had so much potential. And then it got rushed to release to make it on the PS4, and that's where it fell apart. Okay. That is entirely possible as well, Spoon. See, I think I bent the wrong one on that LED. See, here I was talking away, and I think I bent the wrong one on that one. Make sure I didn't bend the wrong one on the other ones. So this one, I bent the wrong lead. I was supposed to bend the shorter of the two leads, and I bent the longer. I'll blame Mr. Wells that I looked over at chat while he was talking. Yeah, I should just pay more attention to what I'm doing. It's an easy enough fix, but that's why, you know, it's nice to catch it before I solder things together. Oh, I figured you would have blamed metric. Because believe it or not, this is a 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter grid. Not bad, that's the only one I messed up so far. I spoke too soon. I screwed up on two of them. Oh, and I got a few new games that I'm going to try and see if they'll stream. I got Alone in Space and Hardware Engineer. They're on sale for like a couple of bucks each, so I snagged them. Don't know how well they're going to stream on my current computer, because we all know how craptastic it is. Stay in their holes. I guess I should move that up to where people can actually see what I'm doing. what I am doing is I am creating a little grid of LEDs that I am going to solder together. Oh, that's nice, Spoon. Yeah, I haven't joined any Kickstarter campaigns. Just none have jumped out and grabbed me enough to actually spend money on them yet. Mainly because I have other things that I need to spend money on, like my computer setup. Let's see, Spider-Mind Games, that's the one that's doing the Elite Dangerous RPG tabletop game. Okay. All right, so we may have an interruption. And stream it a little later. My wife just informed me that somebody may be coming along for their Tupperware. So I'll have to listen out for that. This is the long and tedious part of building an LED cube. This is just one layer. I gotta do this 8 more times. That's why I said this project's gonna take me a couple of streams to get done. Let's see. And thank you for all the auto hosts. just checking that because it's blinking out of the corner of my eye. Telling me that I've got people hosting me. Which I don't think my host alert worked. That makes me wonder if the donation system even works over at Streamlabs. If their alerts don't even frickin' work. Of course, it might be because Twitch changed their API again. Okay, let's continue on here with testing. One thing that's cool about these LED cubes is the way they're assembled, they hold themselves together pretty much. Let me just check something, but I'm pretty sure you're right. Open a new window. Come over here. Streamlabs.com. Log in. Connect with Twitch. Alert box. Yep. My part of it works. It's the APIs broke again. Thank you. So, Mr. Bowles, I know your birthday was a few days ago. Other than the rain, did it go well? Because I know Oregon decided to, be, well, the Pacific Northwest on your birthday. Okay, well, at least it went okay. To think about. Some other stuff on this too. Because there's things with this set that I'm just like, ugh, I want to modify it a little bit. Like for one, the instructions on how to build this thing originally has you build the 8 up the side instead of a whole flat layer. That's nice. Yeah, I've been thinking about getting a Roku, but just not on my priority list right now because I can use my computer to stream and my DVD player out in the living room pretty much does Hulu, Netflix, Amazon Video. I can be monotone for you as well, Spoon. And talk like Ben Stein. Okay, this line, actually, I'm going to have to do something a little different. How did I realize that? Okay, so I'm going to have to go back. Oh, I want you to stay like that. I want a second bend in you. Well, I hope there's spares. Because I just broke my first LED. It's still salvageable, but so I want to bend it about right there, and then like that. See, I always go to Ferris Bueller's Day Off when I think of Ben Stein. Bueller. Bueller. So what I'm doing is, for this row, I've got to connect all of the negatives together, but avoid the positive pins. So I'm having to do this little funky bend. I don't know if you can see it, where it bends that way and then that way. Those are magnetic. Let me get something that's non-magnetic right now. First and then that way. And use the non-magnetic thing to kind of rearrange the pins the way they're supposed to be. So, what all is the people up to tonight? Just trying to think about things to talk about while I'm doing this, because, I mean... guys, it's just me sitting here bending leads and sticking LEDs in holes. I'm sticking things in holes. You sure do like that game, Mr. Wells. Okay. That's part of what we need to do. I'm just gonna look and see. Yep, there we go. Well, I wish you the best of luck, Mr. Wells. Okay. Things are stuck. Okay. All right. We're gonna try this lead-free solder tonight and see how well it works. Not that I'm out of the other stuff, it's just I want to see how well this works. This lead-free solder's not doing too bad on this. I might have to pick some more up, more of it up. In that corner. Well, soldering's not too hard to learn, Mr. Wells. You know, I picked this little kit up off of Amazon. It's a Veilman VTSC40N temperature-controlled soldering station. It's about $100. And then I prefer these tip cleaners, personally. Just the way I am over the sponge. It does wear your tip out faster, but that's why I buy spare tips. And what you do is you set it for, like, I've got it set to 300 degrees Celsius right now. And that's the thing that you'll find is almost all soldering irons will go in Celsius. And what you do, you know, you kind of hold it like a pencil back here on the nice temperature grip. You have your solder in the other hand, and then you apply the heat to what you're working on. And then just tap the solder on there and let it flow in. And if you're bonding two wires together, you know, you just let it kind of wick up the copper and everything until it's solid. Then you clean off the tip if it needs it. Let me make sure I got all my connections here. And there's two types of solder, you know, there's 100 different types of solder that you can get. This came with one of the kits. It's lead-free solder. It's copper and tin. These tend to need a little higher melting point than the lead, the leaded stuff. But this stuff's less toxic. Get back in your hole. Yep. Yes. Heat up what you're going to solder, not the solder itself, because all heating up the solder will do is cause it to flow and then drip off of whatever you're trying to solder. If you heat up the part and then touch the solder to the part, it will actually wick the solder into it. And if it's not wicking well enough, you can use flux. Like, I've got this flux pen that, you know, you put it on there, and what happens is the heat causes that to evaporate and clean off stuff. And then the solder sucks in to replace it as it evaporates. This is alcohol-based. They've got some other ones out there. I like this one because it leaves less of a residue. And it comes in a convenient pen. The other thing that you can get is you can get canisters of flux, and it looks almost like wax in a little container that you can literally dip your wires in the end of it and then solder them together. What the heck? Wires decided they wanted to not cooperate. Sometimes when you're soldering, you need like 6 hands. Where'd that go? How the heck did it end up clear over there? Maybe an 1/8 inch hole was just a little too big for these. They keep wanting to fall out. That's interesting, Mr. Spoon. Yes, but Mr. Wells, sweating copper pipe is a whole nother animal into itself. I've done that too. That requires a torch, and you have to use lead-free solder. So difficult. My viewer count keeps fluctuating. I'm beginning to wonder if that system even works right. Oh wait, it's Twitch. Of course it doesn't.
Thank you. Wow, I don't even know what's going on there. Okay, why is this being so difficult? Oh, hey! Look at that, my alerts work again. Commander Femship is now hosting me. Okay, next row. Let's see if coming at it from this angle helps any. Well, I hope you guys enjoy the music tonight. I downloaded some more stuff from Kevin MacLeod over at incomputech.com. Of course, it's all royalty-free music. I just have to tell you where I got it from. Some of these are being difficult. Am
I even still live? Because I'm... Twitch is being Twitch as normal.
Some partnered streamer must have just got on.
Okay, it looks like it has stopped. But I got two major dips where I was down to where Twitch was only accepting 600 kilobytes per second. And I'm streaming about 3,500. So... yeah, it looks like it stabilized again, though.
Like I said, some partnered streamer probably just came online.
Might try switching servers here. Unless it settles down. Looks like it might be settling down. I'll keep an eye on it. Thank you.
You know, Mr. Wells, my wife has something that you might even be able to use to cook. It's the new microwave grill from Tupperware. I tried it out tonight on a chicken breast. It actually worked pretty good. You stick it in the microwave, run it for about 4 minutes on a side, flip the chicken over, run it for 4 minutes on the other side, and you got a nicely cooked chicken breast. Switch. Stop it.